Are you a redhead? It looks like it. Can't tell if it's the lights.
You are a red.
I am.
Hi. I love redheads.
Oh, thanks.
It's a genetic mutation. You are a real-life X-Men. It's only just occurred to me.
So you were talking about traveling, and I love to travel.
So do I. It's the best. I mean, honestly, that is the best privilege that there is in life, is to travel.
Yeah,
it's
seriously.
The best. That's my favorite thing to do.
So I was wondering what your favorite place to go was and why.
In my life.
Torrance.
Right. Carlsbad.
Right under that. What is the second one? Because that's
right.
Obvious. It's obviously Carlsbad.
Obviously, of course. City of Industry.
Yeah. Ooh.
I've done a lot of traveling in the last couple of years to places I've never been. And they have been some of my favorite trips. I've spent a bit of time in Turkey over the last few years. And that's been really incredible. Istanbul, for anyone who's never been, is a really remarkable place. It's like this crazy... It sits on the edge of Europe and Asia, so it's like this crazy gateway to the Middle East, but it's not really the Middle East, and it's not really Europe. It's really exceptional. And the food is incredible, and the history there is amazing. You've got these mosques that are so massive, but they were at one point, you know, part of an empire that was not Muslim, so they were churches, and then they were reappropriated over time. It's amazing. Food's great. Raqqa is this drink that they drink that's awesome. It's like a ouzo sort of thing, and they add water to it, and they love it, and I love it. Where else? Japan is another favorite. I've only ever been to Tokyo. I've never been outside of Tokyo, but Tokyo is still one of my favorite places on the planet. It's just... I've always loved Japanese culture. I love Japanese food. I love the way that they interpret the Western world and make it their own in such a unique way that only the Japanese can do. It's so awesome. Where else? I mean, obviously New Zealand, guys. Yeah. New Zealand, that's one just sort of goes without saying, I suppose.
Have you ever been to Old Zealand? A lot of people don't get there.
It's nice. Yeah. It's become a bit of the bastard stepchild at this point. Yeah. New Zealand gets all the attention. I'm going to India in September. I've never been to India. I'm going to go play records there in Mumbai and Bangalore. That's going to be crazy. And I'm going to buy crazy Bollywood records from the 70s and 80s, and I can't wait. It'd be awesome. What's that? Singapore? I've never been to Singapore. Never been to Singapore? I should go. I really want to do a big Southeast Asia trip, too. Like, I've been to Thailand. I love Thailand. But I want to do Thailand into, like, Cambodia, Laos, Vietnam, like, the whole... Culinarily, that's a really exciting trip as well. And Africa. I really want to spend more time in Africa. I've only been to Zambia, but I really want to get to... And this doesn't really count, because these are the places I've gone. I'm just telling you places I don't want to go. I can do this for, like, an hour. Nigeria. I really want to go to Nigeria. See, I love music, so some of the trips that I want to take are also really musically driven, like places that I buy records. I buy like Nigerians 1970s and 80s records. I love them. I want to go to Nigeria and like hear the music there. I want to go to Jamaica and, you know, listen to crazy dub music in Jamaica. Like that, you know. And food too, that also drives me. Sorry, I'm really rambling now. It's so past.
I wish we could hear some Nigerian 80s music.
Oh, I know.
Just cue it up. Cue it up. What does that sound like? You have it? What?
Is there Wi-Fi here, you guys? All right,
oh,
good.
It's got a crazy password.
Oh, no, really?
Oh, there's an open network.
Is that NerdHQ? Is that open? Shit, yeah.
What's the you have to give the name of the song too, because that's gonna be in the band as well.
Sure. So this is hang on, I'm gonna do it via Spotify. Hang on, guys.
This is Nigerian.
Yeah, this is Nigerian.
Okay.
Alright.
I'm just checking to see if you listen to the same Nigerian music I listen to. So I'm way into that.
Alright, so this would be, I think, early 80s. Nigerian. This is William Onyebor. Does anybody know who William Onyebor is?
Yes!
And synthesizers in Nigeria. Pretty awesome.
Wow. Are there words to it?
Yeah, there are.
We could have sung along if we got there.
We could have gotten there,
yeah,
but
we could have all sung along
up,
just
wanna...
this side, just that side. That's cool. Thank you for sharing.
Yeah, you're welcome. Check out William Onyebor. He's great. If y'all have a Spotify.
His later stuff got a little weird.
It did, actually, a little bit. It got a little, like, yeah, really digital and funny. I feel like I have that outlet. I play records, and I've done it for a long time for fun, but over the last 4 or 5 years, I've kind of taken it more seriously, and I'm actually taking trips to do that specifically, which is really lovely.
You should DJ here at Comic-Con, like do a hard rock night.
I'm actually DJing tonight, you guys.
Yo! Where are you DJing?
Well, it's a Mashable party. I think if you go to Mashable's Twitter, I'm not sure where it is. If you go to their Twitter, I retweeted it earlier. If you go to mine, actually, I retweeted it earlier, where it's happening. But at 8 o'clock tonight.
Are you DJ something?
No, when I DJ with my friend Zach, and we go under Wooden Wisdom. Because his DJ name is Turquoise Wisdom, and we just dub ourselves Wooden Wisdom. So we're a DJ pair, and we have a musical conversation with records on stage.
I did a porn by that same name. All right, everybody, Elijah Wood!
Nice, thank you so much.
Beautiful. That was fantastic. Cheers. I think I leave too.